Hey everyone, 3Daisy here. Welcome to this complete beginner's walkthrough of the KLORS text-to-image feature on KlingAI. Whether you're completely new to Kling or just want to better understand how the image generation works, this video has got you covered. In this video, we'll walk through every important part of the KLORS interface, including models, prompt inputs, hint suggestions, generation settings, viewing results, and all the buttons and tools you need to get started. Later, I'll also make a follow-up video going deeper into advanced features like using reference images, restyling modes, and more. So let's begin. We start on the Kling AI homepage. We go to the AI generation category and then click on images. This takes us into the core tool we'll be using, the text to image generator powered by KLORS. At the top of the page, you will find a dropdown. This is where you select your image generation model. Currently, Kling offers three models. KLORS 1.0, the original model, KLORS 1.5, an improvement with sharper results, and KLORS 2.0, the latest and most advanced version. Next, let's look at the prompt box where you describe the image you want Kling to generate. Below the prompt box are clickable hints. If you're not sure what to type, click on one of the examples. Let's try modern party. The prompt is added automatically. You can delete it by clicking the trash icon and refresh for new suggestions using the refresh button. Now let's take a quick look at the upload a reference section. This is a powerful tool, but we'll cover it in depth in a separate upcoming video. For now, when you hover over each option, Kling gives you a short explanation. Subject, upload a photo and identify the main subject. Face, upload or choose a face for facial-based generation. Restyle. Change the entire style of your image, for example, from realistic to cartoon. Entire image. Use the full image as a reference. You can click here to upload or choose something from your assets. Just make sure your image is JPEG or PNG. You can also press the hints button for inspiration and hit refresh for more ideas. If you go down to the bottom of the page, you will find your image generation settings. You can choose your resolution, select how many images to generate, up to 9, and pick between standard and high resolution, only available in KLORS 2.0. Let's start by generating an image using KLORS 1.0 and enter this prompt. Let's click Generate. Once your images are ready, click on any of them to view them in full. Let's go through all the tools and buttons you'll see there. Thumbs up or down. Give feedback. It doesn't change this model's output directly, but it helps Kling to improve overall. Publish the paper plane icon. Opens a window where you can title and describe your image. If approved by the Kling team, it may be featured on the Explore page, but remember, others can see your prompt and download your image and even clone your work. Let's go to the next. Download the arrow icon. Only works without a watermark if you are on a paid plan. The three dots. Report inappropriate content or delete the image. The star icon marks the image as a favorite for easier access later. Below, you can find more powerful options. Generate video. Send the image into the video generator. In Paint, edit a specific part of the image. Expand. Add more visual content around the image. Set as a reference. Use the image to influence future generations. Upscale. Increase image resolution. Edit, return to your prompt input, and retry, generate again with the same prompt. Let's now try the same prompt using KLORS 1.5. As you can see, the result is different. Here I got a regular panda instead of a red one. And that's important to remember. AI isn't perfect. Each model interprets prompt differently. Rerolls are part of the process. Just give a thumbs down and try again if needed. Now let's move on to KLORS 2.0. First, I will choose standard resolution and generate the same prompt. Once they are ready, I click on an image, scroll down to the rest using the mouse wheel or the right side image strip and favorite the ones I like. Then I will switch to high resolution and again I scroll through and mark my favorites. Now that we are back on the main image page, look at the top center. Click on favorites to find all your starred images. You can filter by images, video, or audio. And that's it, the full walkthrough on how to use KLORS for text-to-image generation on Kling AI. You now know how to choose models, write prompts, use hints, set your output settings, and manage your results. In upcoming videos, I'll dive deeper into the uploader reference options, restyling modes, and even how to turn your image into an AI-generated video. So if this helped you, give this video a like, subscribe to the channel, and leave a comment below with your favorite AI creation or prompt. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.